बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द नाइन्थ लेक्चर ऑफ सेकेंड ईयर केमिस्ट्री एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग चैप्टर 16 विच इज अबाउट द हाइड्रोकार्बन्स। सो इन माई लास्ट लेक्चर वी स्टार्टेड द टॉपिक आइसोमरिज्म एंड वी सेड दैट आइसोमरिज्म मीन्स organic compound having same molecular formula but different chemical structures. That term is called as isomerism. And we said that this isomerism is of two types. One is called as structure isomerism and second is called as stereoisomerism. So structure isomerism means organic compounds having same molecular formula but different structural formulas, that is called a structural isomerism. And on the basis of structural isomerism, we said we have five types: chain isomerism, functional group isomerism, position isomerism, metamerism, and tautomerism. So today in our lecture we will discuss the second class or second type of isomerism, that is called a stereoisomerism. That is called as stereoisomerism, and this stereoisomerism is very important for our knowledge because it has a number of applications as organic chemist. So stereoisomerism is of two types: optical isomerism as well as the geometrical isomerism. So we will discuss these two types in detail in our lecture. So stereoisomerism, first come to the stereoisomerism. So that isomerism in which molecules have same structure formula, same molecular formula, but differ in the arrangement of atoms in space, means they have only the differ in the geometry of molecule, and this geometry of molecule is called as configuration. So we can say that the when isomerism is caused by the different arrangement orientation of atoms or groups in space, that is called as stereoisomerism. So just same molecular formula, same structure formula, but their arrangement in space is different. So there are two kinds of stereoisomerism. One is called as optical isomerism and second is called as geometrical or cis-trans isomerism. So we will discuss these two types. First, move to the optical isomerism. But before going to the optical isomerism, we have to learn some important definitions about these optical isomerism. First, there is a main thing that is called as plane of symmetry. So a plane which divides an object into two symmetrical halves is said to be plane of symmetry. So we can say that plane is that line which divides the object into two halves. For example, if we have this hat and we draw a line, it can equally divide it, symmetrically divide it into two halves. It means this hat has a plane of symmetry. Similarly, a person that has a plane of symmetry means it can be equally divided into two halves, symmetrical halves. So that object which having plane of symmetry, they are called as symmetric molecules or symmetric objects. And on the other hand, person hand or the gloves, they don't have a plane of symmetry. Such type of objects, they are called as dissymmetric. So these are some definitions of that one. So object lacking a plane of symmetry, that is called as dissymmetric, or they are called as chiral. So for example, if this is, we have this hand, so it lacks plane of symmetry, mean we cannot pass the plane of symmetry over the hand. So it means if we cut from the middle, it's not identical into two parts. So that kind of situation is called as dissymmetry, or it is special term that is called as the chiral. On other hand, such substances through which a plane of symmetry can pass, they are called as symmetric or achiral. So It means we have two kinds of objects on the basis of symmetry. One is called dissymmetric or symmetric. So those dissymmetric objects, they have some special feature, and this is very important point, that a dissymmetric object cannot be superimposed on its mirror image. Means if we have the left hand and if I take its mirror image into the mirror, if you see in the mirror, it looks like a right hand. It means left hand and its mirror looks like a right hand. Means these two images cannot superimpose, and this is the property of those objects which are dissymmetric. So dissymmetric objects cannot be superimposed on its mirror images. A left hand, for example, does not possess a plane of symmetry, and its mirror image is not another left hand but a right hand. So up to now we said that there are some objects which may be symmetric, which may be dissymmetric, which have the plane of symmetry, which don't have the plane of symmetry. Similarly, organic compounds, they can also be symmetric or dissymmetric on the basis of plane of symmetry. So those molecules, those organic compounds which don't have a plane of symmetry, or in other words, through which a plane of symmetry cannot pass, those objects or those molecules are called as chiral molecules or dissymmetric molecules. And those molecules through which a plane of symmetry can pass, they are called as symmetric molecules. So this carbon, that is called as chiral center. So we can identify that which molecule is symmetric and which molecule is dissymmetric. So for that purpose, a carbon atom which is bonded to four different groups, that is called as asymmetric carbon atom. So this is asymmetric carbon atom, and it is bonded to four different groups. Mean we cannot pass a plane. For example, if I line over here, it is not equally dividing these two parts. If I cut from here, it is not equally divided into two parts. So this molecule is dissymmetric, and this is a chiral molecule. And this, if we cut from here, so it can equally divide into two parts. It means this molecule is symmetric molecule. So on the basis of plane of symmetry, organic compound can be divided into symmetric, into asymmetric. And these asymmetric molecules, or the chiral molecules, they have very special feature. So these organic molecules which are asymmetric, mean dissymmetric or chiral, they have a special property. They can rotate the plane of polarized light. So if I need to discuss, as these compounds are called optical active, and this property is called as optical activity. Mean this is the special property of those organic molecules which are dissymmetric, asymmetric or chiral. Means they don't have a plane of symmetry. And for that purpose, we have this diagram. We need to understand this experiment. So this is the light source. So these, it's light, it can rotate in all the planes. But when it is passed through one prism, this is called Nicol prism. So the purpose of this prism is to absorb all the light and emit only one light which is rotating in one plane. That is called polarized light or plane polarized light, meaning which is moving in one plane. And this is the tube having the solution of the organic compound. So when it is, this light passed through this solution, there are two possibilities. Either this light passes straight without rotating, either this light rotates at some angle. So these organic compounds which are chiral, if they are placed in this solution, they will rotate this light to some angle, to some degree. It means first this was the plane, but now it rotates like this one. So that kind of molecule which rotate this light, they are called as optical active compounds, and this is called optical activity. So there are two options. are two possibilities. Either these organic compound will rotate this light towards the right, that are called as dextrorotatory. And if these molecules rotate the light towards the left or anticlockwise, that is called as levorotatory. And we can find the magnitude, that is called as observed rotation, or that is called as the alpha. So these are the points. The compound which rotates the plane of polarized light to the right clockwise is said to be dextrorotatory. It is indicated with the plus sign. The compound which rotates the plane of polarized light to the left, they are called as levorotatory and indicated by the negative sign. So the magnitude of rotation in degree is referred to as the observed rotation. Means optical active compounds, they can rotate the light in two direction, either clockwise, either anticlockwise. Means one isomer will rotate either clockwise, second isomer will rotate into the anticlockwise. So on those organic compounds which are optical active, mean they show the term optical activity, such type of isomerism is called as optical isomerism. So an optical active compound can exist in two isomeric form which rotate the plane of polarized light in opposite direction. They are called as optical isomers, and phenomena is known as optical isomerism. Mean optical isomerism is shown by those compound which are optical active. And optical active means they can rotate the light either clockwise, either anticlockwise. And optical active compounds are those which don't have a plane of symmetry, mean which are the chiral. In simple word, I say chiral molecule has the ability to show the term optical isomerism. So let's discuss some types, some example showing optical isomerism. So one of them is the lactic acid. 2-hydroxypropaneoic acid. So this is 2-hydroxypropaneoic acid. So this is one of the structure. If I make this dotted line, mean we see in the mirror, its diagram will be like this one. This OH on the left side, now this OH on the right side. It means this is the one isomer and this is the second isomer. So that acid is positive, mean this will rotate the light to the right. That acid will rotate the light to the left. It means this is dextrorotatory, that is the levorotatory, and this is three dimensional diagram of this molecule. So this molecule can exist in three forms: 50% dextrorotatory or the plus acid, negative acid, and there is third possibility that tube has 50% of both, 50% positive and 50% negative. Now what will happen? The light will move straight. That kind of situation is called as the racemic mixture. So this lactic acid exists in three forms: plus acid, negative acid, and plus minus acid. That is called as the racemic mixture. Another example, that is tartaric acid, 2,3-dihydroxybutane-dioic acid. So this is the structure of formula of this tartaric acid. So we can see this is the carbon attached with four different groups. I mean this carbon is a chiral. This carbon is again attached with four different groups. This is also chiral. It means this molecule has two chiral centers. So if they have the two chiral center, then there is a possibility of four kinds. So this is the one of the molecule or when isomers. If I take the mirror, they will be inverted. This OH on the left side, this OH will be on the right side. So this is the positive. This is the negative acid. Mean this acid will rotate the light to the right side, this will rotate the light to the left side. And the third possibility is if both OH on the one side. When both OH on the one side, we can pass a plane. Such kind of acid is called as mesoform or mesoacid. And the fourth form, plus and negative. That is called racemic mixture. So we can say that tartaric acid exists in four forms: plus, minus, plus minus, and mesoform or the mesoacid. So these two isomers which are mirror image to each other, they are called as enantiomers. So that's we discussed in optical isomerism. And the second type, which is also important, that is called geometrical isomerism or cis-trans isomerism. And that kind of isomerism arises have those molecules which have a restricted rotation, which might be in double bonded alkenes or in the cyclic compounds. So I say that geometrical isomerism results from a restriction in rotation about double bonds or about single bonds in cyclic compounds. For example, if we have this alkene, we can see that this is a butene, and in this double bond, one is sigma bond and one is the pi bond. So this pi bond is formed by the parallel overlap of these p orbital, which are unhybridized. So each carbon is sp2 hybridized, we know. So this pi bond, it restricts the rotation of these groups. So these groups may be on the one side, mean same side, or these groups may be on the opposite side. So they make two isomers due to the restriction around this double bond. This is called geometrical isomers, and this term is called as geometrical isomerism or cis-trans isomerism. So its name is cis-2-butene because these two groups, they are on the same side, or we can say the hydrogens, they are on the same side. And this is called as trans-2-butene because these two hydrogens, they are on the opposite side. Or in other word, I say these methyl are on the opposite side. So they differ. They are the two isomers. So they differ in the boiling point. So its boiling point is 4 degree centigrade, and trans has a boiling point of 1 degree centigrade. So there are some features. All the alkene, they did not show this kind of isomerism. So for geometrical isomerism, there is a very special rule or very special prerequisite for this alkene. And according to this necessary condition, this double bonded carbon, so the groups attached to this double bonded carbon, they should be different. So if we can see that this carbon, over here we have methyl and we have the hydrogen, it means these are different. But this carbon, over here these two hydrogens, they are similar. It means this carbon is not bonded to two different groups. So we can say that this alkene will not show cis-trans isomerism. But this hexene, this is 3-hexene, this will show because this carbon has two groups, two different groups attached to each carbon. So this is cis and this is the trans. So we can say that this alkene can show cis-trans isomerism. So first we have to learn that which alkene will show this kind of isomerism, and then we will see that which isomer is cis and which is a trans. So we can say that these two hydrogens, they are on the same side, it means this is cis-3-hexene, and these hydrogens are on the opposite side, that is called trans-3-hexene. So this is another example. This is butene dioic acid, and they exist in two forms, cis as well as the trans, and they have special feature that their melting points are totally different. So in this case, these two carboxyl group or these two hydrogens are on the opposite side. So this is trans-butene dioic acid, and it is called as fumaric acid, and its second isomer is called malic acid. So two hydrogens, they are on the similar side, that is called as the malic acid, and they have totally different melting points, 288 degree centigrade and 130 degree centigrade. So it means for geometrical isomerism, there is some necessary things that the groups attached to each carbon, they should be different, and that might be cis and that might be the trans. So these alkenes or these isomers can be converted. So the conversion of cis isomer into the trans isomer or vice versa, it can be done by the applying of some heat. So for example, this is the cis isomer. If we heat that one, so this bond will break, the pi bond will break, and these are the unhybridized p orbital. Then there are two possibilities. Either one of them will rotate and this group will move over here, and we are getting the transform, and then the overlap. So they will bond together again, and we are getting the transform. And the second possibility is, if this knot going to rotate and they overlap again, and we get the sesalki. So this conversion of ses into trans or vice versa can be done in the presence of heat. And generally, the trans isoform, the trans form is more stable than the ses. The reason of this trans form than the ses is that the groups are in the opposite position, they will be more stable as compared to the ses, because in the ses, the groups are present on the same side, which causes the hindrance of that one. Next, come to the geometrical isomerism, which is in the cyclic compounds, and the cyclic compound also shows the geometrical isomerism because of the restriction of the bond. So the two adjacent carbons, if the groups on the two adjacent carbons, they are on the same side, this will be the cis, and if these, we can see these hydrogen on the opposite side, that is called as the trans. So this molecule will not show the geometrical isomerism because the adjacent carbon, it has two hydrogens, so it will not show the cis geometrical isomerism, and this molecule will all show the geometrical isomerism. And that's all we discussed in our lecture, that there are two kinds of stereoisomerism, optical isomerism as well as the geometrical isomerism. Thanks, and if you have any question, you can ask me in the comment box and we will discuss. Good luck.